Vedic Sanatan Rajasakti, a female form of divine energy to rule this world. In the old times, the kings ruled in the name of the people's Ganatantra or Devata Dharma, seeking the lineage right over the land and people. Rulers' right to rule over people, land, let's call it Rajasakti, consisting of Raja, Rajya, and Praja. Rajasakti as physical form embraced as Rajadanda or sword, sitting on throne, people accepting that Rajanaha authority when Dharma rites done. Coronation. It is documented that from Asukan Empire times up to 1947, the ancient king's lineage ruled this way. Rules sanctioned by Dharma, people's lineage. Kings fought each other as warlord to increase their territories, but basis remained same, the Dharma and people. Then invaders, warlords came from Islamic world to enforce their supposed claim right over our ancient land and peoples using sword. Ultimately, around 1707, Maratha Confederation stood up throughout these invaders from most of India, 80% landmass in 1802, and established the Hindvi Swaraj based on the Dharma. This was acceptable by people. Please note that Marathas killed the Mughal Empire up to from Bengal. Calcutta came the East India Company and won from Marathas and then rest of India using guns and alliance. In 1905, King Emperor honored Rajasakti by coronation and proclaiming himself King Emperor. Up to 1947, we had Desi King sitting with Dharma rituals, and King of England was titular King Emperor of India. This is all historical facts and can be checked from various authentic sources. When British Parliament partitioned the ancient land of India, we gave Bengal to Muslim rule. Okay, then half Punjab, Sindh, which had more Hindu Sikhs, to Muslim rule. Not okay. Pakistan established the Islamic rule under their constitution. Now India remained with two systems: British Indian Dominion and Desi Hindu kingdoms. British monarchs seek divine sanction to rule. However, the British Parliament has taken over day-to-day functions of the state. There, the Rajasakti is the Christian and intact. In East and West Pakistan, it's Islamic, and in Desi kings, it was the Hindu or Sanatana Vedic Rajasakti. In Indic states, Desi kings, the people have right over their kings. People sought Dharma, freedom. The Rajasakti always emanated from the Dharma and worked for the preserving Dharma and people. In above context, my question is, what happened to this Rajasakti? Does it merge into anywhere? Is it living? Is it dead? There is no mention of it in our constitution. As a secular state, we denied the Dharma, Dharma lineage, and people's right over the state. We denied this Rajasakti benefit to peoples. How we can reconcile this evaporation, annihilation of the Rajasakti by constitution makers and their right to do so? What should be our democratic method and tool to revive this Sanatana Vedic Rajasakti into our present constitution? With what little change we can reconcile this to create the Vedic Sanatana Rashtra, upholding the ancient and modern values and acceptable to all. What is the authority basis of state claiming over this land and people? Under which lineage and principle the state is bound itself? How we can explain this to ourselves? Do we people own this constitution, or the constitution own the people and land? Once again, we need answer to the most important question: what happened to our Sanatana Vedic Rajasakti? Shiv ka Shasan hai, Shiv ka Shasan hai.